So let me continue again from the for the your wind analysis part.
So here I will create the structure through the structure wizard, or you can create your own structure also. So here I will pick a default structure from bay frame, and I will do the wind analysis for a building structure. Then after, I will do it for other structures like water tank or transmission tower also. Okay, so just see here, the total height of the building is 15 meter, and the length is 12 meter, and the width is also 12 meter, and the division along the length is 4, and that mean the distance between the each column will be along the x-axis will be 3 meter. And here in along the width, I'm going to change the width to the 16 meter and division to the 4. That means the division between the width will be 4 meter. That means the distance between each column along the width will be 4 meter. You can see it here and apply it. So here it is your structure. Then just transfer this structure to your Stat Pro. Now, next thing will be provide the properties. So for the beam, going to create the property of 0.3 by 0.23 here. Then 0.3 5, okay. So 0.3 is for the beam. So I will assign it to the beam, which is parallel to the X and Z. And for this, either select the beam parallel to Y axis, or you can assign this value through the attributes also, like through the missing properties. Okay, so you can see you can assign it through the missing properties also. We can select the columns through this also. Okay, so now beam and column has been assigned with the properties. You can see it through the render view. Now, next thing will be I will create the support for your building structure. It will be a fixed support. Now, I will assign this fixed support to the bottom of the nodes here. Now, come to the loading. So, here for the wind analysis, you can give the definition anytime. Mean after defining the dead and live load, you can give the definition for the wind analysis also. Okay, or give the definition first, it doesn't matter. But in case of the seismic analysis, definition must be given before creating any other load case. Okay, so here I will create the dead load and live load first. Then after, I will give the definition. So first I will create a dead load. Under the dead load, I will give the self weight. Then after, the load of the brick wall 18.8, and then after, your floor load due to the weight of slab. And we have to define the range also. Then this member load will be assigned to the beam. Self weight will be assigned to the complete structure, that means assigned to the view option. And floor load will be defined by itself, don't need to assign it. Now come to the live load. under the live load, again we will do apply the floor load due to the human beings or any other live load. Range will be 0 to 15 one more time. Now come to the definition. So for the definition, first let me open a PDF. Just wait. Oh, sorry. Okay. So here it is. So come to the definition and go to the win definition, click on the add, then provide the number that is the type number one or anything. You can provide any number and you can type your comment also here, like win from x or y, anything x and z. So you can edit the win one, that is the definition first. Next thing will be just select it now. So here we have an intensity versus height diagram. That means sometimes the data will be given, like you have to, there will be, I will show you a assignment for that. Just wait, then it will be very clear to you. So here it is an assignment. In this assignment you can see the details of the wind load here. So here we have the wind definition parameters like intensity versus height table. Okay, at a height of 5 meter, intensity of the wind is 1.05 kilonewton per meter square, and at a height of 10 meter the intensity value is the 1.12 kilonewton per meter square. So this is the wind definition parameter. So either sometimes you will get the data according to this, or sometimes we have to give it according to the Indian design code. But in the StatPro, under the wind definition, we don't have the Indian design code. So here either do the manual calculation for the height versus intensity value, or use the ASCE code, then change the parameters according to the Indian design code. So I will just use it according to the ASC7 code. Then here you will, first thing will be your building classification category. So now I'm just going to explain it. So in the Indian design code, you will see it as a terrain category also, with the name of terrain category. I will show you the terrain category. Just wait. So here first terrain is the terrain category 1, that is the building classification categories. Okay. So let me explain it. In the terrain category, in the terrain category 1, you will see a open place with almost no obstacles here. And in the terrain category 2, you will see very few obstacles here presents. The height of the obstacles in the terrain category 1 will be approximate 0 to 1.5 meter, and in terrain category 2 it will be from 1.5 to 10 up to the 10 meter height. So, and in the terrain category 3 you can see here is the very few obstacles, but these obstacles are here is placed in a in group formats. You can see here, there, here it is a few groups of the obstacles, then at the, with the spacing there is another group of obstacles. So this will be your terrain category 3, that is the building classification category.
Then after you will see a terrain category 4. So most of the time terrain category 4 is used for your cities. Okay, like here you can see the distribution obstacles are in the format of building structures. So mostly for the building purpose we use the terrain category 4, and for the transmission towers like electricity transmission tower we use the terrain categories 1, 2, and 3. Okay, then after this next thing will be your wind intensity, that will be your wind speed. So for the wind speed I will show you here. Here you can see the zones of the wind speeds. So with you are seeing a blue color. So this is the area where the wind speed will be 55 meter per second. Okay, for the green color it is 47 meter per second. It is written here. You can see it from the table. You can see it from the in graphical format, and you can see it in the table also. To show it in the table, there will be a classification. Let me show you. Just wait. Control. You can find it through the pressing the control F. Then type any city names. Like I want to search it for the Lucknow. Just type this name in this city. Yeah, so here it is the appendix A. Under this you will see city names and the basic wind speed. Okay, so for the Lucknow it is the 47, for the Lakshadweep it is 39 meter per second, and for the Kolkata it is 50 meter per second. Okay, so now come to the software. Here first thing will be just select your building classification category. So I'm just selecting it the category 4. Then after basic wind speed, okay, then it should be in the meter per second according to the Indian design code. And if I am doing it for any city like Lucknow, then you know that for the Lucknow it was 47 meter per second, and for any other cities you have to put this value according to the this appendix, that is that this is the table clause 5.2. you can see it according to this values. Okay, now next thing will be just select the exposure category. So here we have total 3 type of exposures: exposure B, exposure C, and exposure D. So let me explain what's the mean of these exposures. So exposure B means structure are closely spaced and provide a surface roughness. Okay, that means the height of the structures will be different and the structure will be placed very closely. Okay, then after the next is your exposure C. So exposure C means flat open areas with scattered obstructions. That means in the exposure C, so this will be a combination. That means if I'm using the building classification category 1, building classification category 2, in that condition exposure should be C type, because in the classification category 1 structures was in the class building class terrain category 2, that is a building classification category, in the 2 the obstacle objects was placed in the scattered format. Okay, that means they were distributed as in scattered format. That's why we have to select the exposure C here. And for the building, for the classification category 4, that means the structures are very closely spaced.
so we have to select the exposure category B, because under the B the structures are closely spaced and provide a rough surface. Okay, that's why for the category 4 we will select the exposure value B. Then you have to select the type of structure. Is it a building structure or water tank or any other type of tank? So you have to select it through the structure type. So you can see here under the structure type we have building structure, chimney, tank and similar structure. Then there is a solid signs board, open signs, and lattice framework. That will there will be your lattice framework means it will be your truss towers wagera. Oh, sorry, it will be your pedestal tower, any other things. And the here it is the truss tower. That means for the transmission tower, we will select the truss tower option here. Okay, so here you know that I just create a structure of a building, so that's why I will select the building structure. So whenever I will explain the steel design, so there in the steel design I will do the wind analysis again for the truss tower also. Okay, so now come to the next point. After this you have to click on apply, then come to the main building data. So here we have to provide the building data, like what is the height of the building and width and length also of the building. So here you know that either give the value exact, either give the exact value or just you can provide the higher value of the building size. Like for the building height, I have to provide the height value up to the 15 meter or above the 15 meter also. Like if I select it to the meter, let me convert it into the meter. Okay, and the building natural frequency will be 2 hertz. Okay, so either provide the building height, it was 15 meters, so put the value 15, or you can put the any value greater than 15 here. Okay, so same thing, I'm just not going to change these values. And next thing will be your damping ratios. Okay, so for the wind analysis, the damping ratio is the 0.01%. same for the seismic analysis, the damping ratio is of 5%, that is the 0.05%. okay, so these are the few default values, so I will not change it. Next thing is the enclosure classification. So for the building structure, most of the time we use the partially enclosed, because in the building structure we have the opening also, opening for the staircase, opening for your door and windows also. But if your building structure is a shopping mall or any other thing, so most of the time you know that the shopping malls is almost very it will be almost enclosed building, so that's why you can select it. And sometimes maybe your building type will be any truss tower, like any pedestal bridge or anything, so these will be your open buildings, so you can select in them according to that also. Okay, so here you know that it is a building, it is a residential building, so I will select the partially enclosed here, then click on the apply. Next thing will be your building design process. So here you will get the direction, like windward, leeward and sidewall. So windward direction means wind is directly striking on the face of the building, and the sidewall means wind is striking on the sidewall. Okay, and the next one is the leeward, that means at the back wall of the wind. So if your structure is open building, or it is any close, if it is a closed building, then we have to apply it on the windward only. Okay, and if it is any open structure, then you can select according to that also. But you can either select it from here, or we will get this option one more time when I will give the wind load. Okay, so here I'm not going to change it to the leeward or sidewall. So whenever you apply the leeward, that means at the last wall of the building, then sidewall will be included automatically. You can see it when I will give the wind from the load case details. So I will show this thing one more time. So here now you can see the height versus intensity value has been written here. Okay, so the total height I considered as a 40 meter. That's why we are getting the data for the up to the 40 meter height. Okay, now I will add it. Then it will ask for the exposure factor. So for the exposure factor will be applied to the one every time. Then assign this exposure factor to the view. Now come to the load case detail. So dead load and live load has been defined and assigned already. Now I will give the win load also. So before applying this, I will save the structure one time. Yeah, so now come to the load case detail and click on the add. Go to the loading type. So here I will give a wind load and provide its name WL. So if you are going to assign the wind load from the x-axis, so you can write the WL with the sign. If you are going to assign it from the positive x-axis, so just provide the value WL plus x. So you can write anything here, but giving the exact value, that is the plus x. So whenever any person will see the load title, then he will be able to read, recognize the type of the wind load. Okay, so you can add it or you can skip this also. I can write anything here. Okay, so now come to the WL and go to the add option. So here we have the option wind load. So under the wind load, you will get the exposed surface and direction. So I just last time I was explaining that there is a windward direction. That means the wind will directly strike on the front face, and leeward and side wall will be considered at the same time. So you can see here leeward and side wall both are written here. That means if the wind is coming from the positive x direction, then this wind will strike directly on this wall. And if we want to change the wind direction, then we have to change the factor value here. Okay, so how we will change the direction? Just provide the value factor value minus one here. So I will change these values also. For first I will show you it from the positive x direction. So just select the windward face direction to the x. Don't change the factor value here, and even don't provide the range here. If you don't provide the range here, then it will strike. It will show you the output. So it will show you output for complete structure. Just see. Yeah. So you can see the wind is coming from the positive x direction. Is going towards the positive x direction. Now I'm going to edit it. If I change the factor value to the minus one here, then you can see the direction of the wind has been changed. Now this time again, if you want to see the wind load on the leeward face, so just change it to the minus x. That means now the wind will strike at the last wall. So if it strike on the last wall, that means it is going from the windward face, then from the side wall, and then after at the leeward direction. So you can see it here. The wind is striking at the last wall, and that's mean it is going through the side wall. Okay, that's why the leeward and side wall is written here in a single space. Okay, now again going to explain you the range options. So if here you can see, if the wind is coming from the positive x direction, that means it is going towards the positive x direction, that means it will strike on the face of the building which is lying along the z axis. That means here we can change the range value in z and y direction. You can see it. If I change the z range to 8 meter, so you can see it is striking on only these two, 4 meter here and 4 meter here. It is the 8 meter. If I change it to the 9, still it will apply on a distance of up to the 8 meter only. Okay, if I change it to the 12, then after it will be strike on the other, up to the other column. Okay, same along the y. If I change the value to the 5 meter, then it will be shown on the only 1 meter, because 3 meter, then the next floor will be at a height of 6 meter. That means you have to put the value, maximum value, up to the 6 meter. That in that condition you will see it for the another floor. Okay, so this is the stuff here. So either define the value or just put the 00 in everything so that you will get the value for the thing. And same thing, if the wind is coming from the z axis, so just change the windward face towards the z, so you will be able to see it. Okay, so I'm just going to analyze it for the x axis only. Next thing will be, first I will analyze it, and then after I will check the lateral load cases. Okay, so how to check the lateral load case mean that, that mean here you can see the wind is coming from the positive x axis. Yeah, we can say that is coming from the x axis. That mean the wind will apply the load from the lateral load cases. Lateral load cases means from the x axis or z axis. Okay, that mean this building will take displacement in the x, in along the x direction, and due to this load will our structure survive or not. So we can check it through the lateral load cases. So how I will check it, so just see it. So first thing will be, I will go to the analysis and design option, then come to the analysis command and select it for the all and close it. Okay, now the next thing will be, come to the post analysis command. Click on the post analysis command and go to the defined commands. So here we have anything like you can see the story drift. So to and check the lateral load cases, we do the story drift. We apply the story drift command. So for the wind analysis, it is given for 0.0025, and for the seismic we have the allowable drift factor 0.004. So I will change it to the 0.0025 for the wind load. Now I will run the analysis. Now come to the output. So just here you can see in the result story drift. So just double click on story drift and you can see at base level that was the zero, then you can see it was pass. Okay, then at the next is the base level two, that at a height of 3 meter, you can see our structure is pass here also. Okay, then after, next thing will be that through this here you can see it, up to the 15 meter height our structure is passed for the lateral load cases. So here from the story drift you can check the structure's response in the lateral direction. Okay, now come to the post processing here. Now I will show you the animation options also. So you can check the deflection due to the lateral load cases also. The wind was striking directly on the positive x axis, so more maximum deflection will be along this side. And you can see the displacement result also. You can see the maximum displacement along the x-axis is here at the node number 88, and the maximum displacement value is 15.138 mm. So you can see the maximum displacement is along the lateral direction, not along the y direction. Okay, maximum value along the y, you will see the maximum y is 0.074 mm only. Okay, and along the x it is 15.138 meters. Okay, so like yeah, you can see the story drift. Okay, so that is the procedure of defining the wind load details. Okay, so now I will create one more structure. And this time I will create a structure of water tank so that how to apply the hydrostatic load cases will be very clear in this method. So just see, I'm just going to create a new project. Okay. So first I will show you one assignment for this. Let me check one more thing. What is it? Yeah. So here we have total two types of water tank. So this is a water tank which is created by the plate only. So here you will not get the beam and column. This water tank is created by the plates only. That means for this water tank, if we do the concrete design, we will get the area of the steel only. And the second one is of this type. So here we have the column and beam also, and at the top we have the plate also. So here I will do the water tank design for this type of structure first. Okay, and then after I will share this project also for your practice purpose. So let's start with this. I will do few changes also in this structure. Like I will reduce the number of column here, as I am seeing there are many columns, so I will reduce the number of columns. And also I am getting the properties of the column is very high, that is a circular 600 mm. Okay, so first thing I will explain how to create this type of structure. So in the first session of the day one, I explained the circular grid system, and even we can create it through the circular repeat option also. So I will do here, I will do it through the circular repeat methods. So dia of this water tank is 10 meter, that means the radius will be 5. Okay, and note down the number of column. We are going to create the 10 columns here. Okay, only the 10 columns. Height is of 4 meter up to the first beam, then again it will be 4. That means total height of the tower is 10 meter, 4 plus 4 plus 2, it is 10 meter. Dia is 10, height is also 10. Okay, so let's start it. Come to the stat pro. First just create a single beam of 5 meter length, because the diameter of the water tank is 10. That's why I create a beam of 5 meter length only. Now I will do the circular repeat, and I will change the number of step
according to the number of columns. Like if it is a, if there is number of column 8, then I will put the number of step to 8. If the column are 10, then just put the value 10. And after, axis of rotation will be along y-axis. Okay, then click on the link step and click OK. So by this you can see it has been repeated. Now just click on at this node through the beam cursor. So here I am clicking on the node through the beam cursor. That's mean all the beam which is connected with this node will be selected. Okay, and just delete them. Now you can see we have the total 10 nodes here, and on this node we will use the translational repeat for the columns. Okay, so just select this structure, click on the translational repeat, and direction will be global Y, number of step will be 2, and the spacing will be 4. You can see it in your PDF also. I can show you. So first here we have the bottom nodes, and we will repeat it for the 2 times. First will be at 4 meter, again second will be at a distance of 4 meter. Okay, so just do it and click on the link step, press OK. Now just remove the bottom nodes, bottom beams, because at the bottom is not required. So the column and beam has been created. You can see it here. Next thing will be create plate here at the top. So we will create the plate through the structure wizard. So under the structure wizard, we have an option of surface plate model and a circular plate with hole. So we have to reset it to remove the hole. Now just provide the boundary values. Radius of the circle is 5 meter, so change the value to the 5 here, and the division along the periphery, I'm just going to create 20 divisions. Then normal vector will be, origin will be 0 0 0, and the normal vector will be along 0 1 0, because the plate will be in normal direction. Normal means just opposite of the tangent direction, so it will be in normal direction along the y-axis. Okay, you can see it here. That's why it will be placed at the top. Okay, if you don't give the value along the y, if you provide it along the z, then the plate will be placed here, but it will be not normal to the y direction. It will be normal to the x or z, which direction you will set. Okay, so here I have to close it. That's why we will put the y value 1, that means normal vector value 1 along the y-axis. Now just transfer it and provide the y. Here we have to put the y value to 4 plus 4 8 meter. That's why this plate will be placed at the top. Okay, so you can see. Next thing will be create the cylindrical surface for water storing, to store the water. So just go to the structure wizard again and pick the surface plate model and a cylindrical surface. Length will be 2 meter, radius will be 5 and 5, start radius is 5 and radius is also 5, and again the axis will be, start value will be along 0 0 0, and the end will be 0 1 0. Now come to the division along the length. So here you are seeing it is 6, so it's okay. Along the height it is going to be divided in 6 equal parts, but along the periphery it should be same as it was for the circular plate. So for the circular plate I provide the division value 20. That's why we have to put the value 20 here again. If we change it to the 21 or anything else, so it will give you an instability error, because just see, whenever when I transfer this model at a height of 8 meter here, yeah, just going to show you through the
calculate cursor. So just see the joint point here. This is the plate of a circular plate, and this is the plate of your cylindrical plate. And you can see here the joint are at a same point. But if I change the number of division, like different values, like for the circular, if I put the 20 and for it is other than 20, then this node will not be placed at same point. In that condition, we will get an error of instability or warning of the instability. That's why we should provide this value identical. Okay, I think up to this point, how we create the structure is clear to everyone. If you have any doubt after this point, then please ask. If you don't have any doubt, then I'm just going to continue. Now, I will provide the property in support, then after loading for this. So up to the property and the support, it is very clear. Only the loading part is going to be complicated for you. So I will try to explain it very slowly. Just see it. So for the property, first I will give the I will define it. Let me save the structure up to this point. So come to the define. For the column, I'm just going to provide a column of 500 mm thick dia. So I will provide the value 0.5 here, not the 0.6 as it was in your assignment. So I will change it to the 0.5, that is the 500 mm. And the rectangular beam here, it is of 250 mm. So I will provide it the same value for the rectangular. That will be your supporting beams. So I will provide it the 0.25 by 0.25, that is the 250 mm. For this plate in this project, it is showing the plate thickness of 150 mm. I think it is very less, maybe it will pass or fail. So I will, according to the output, if the requirement is come to change it, then I will change it. Okay, so let me define it as it is written here. It is the 150 mm, so I will change, I will give the plate thickness here 150 mm. Okay, but I think for the circular plate, we the thickness of the circular plate must be more than 150 mm. I just, because maximum load will be bear by this circular plate, that is the bottom plate. Okay, and the side plate, that is your cylindrical plate, will also be face the hydrostatic load. Okay, so let's see how to apply this. So come to the thickness option. So here first I'm going to provide it 0.15 for each plate. Okay, and assign it to the view. For the column, just select the beam which is parallel to the y-axis. Now come to the plate. So I already assigned the plate thickness to the beam. One more thing, let me delete the plate thickness because I want to explain a very important thing. Just see it. If the plate thickness for the both structures is different, like for the cylindrical plate it is 0.15, and for the circular plate it is 0.2, that is the 200 mm, then how to assign it. So first thing will be, let me give the thickness one more time, 0.15, okay, and add it. So 0.15 is for the cylindrical plate. So just arrange the structure in the front view, then after this, through the plate cursor, select the plate. Let me select it. I will show you how to select it. Just select the plate through the drag system, but don't select the complete plate, because through this your cylindrical plate will also be selected. Okay, you can see it here, the cylindrical plate, cylindrical plus circular, both plate has been selected. Okay, so that's why just select it like this. Okay, now you can see only the cylindrical plate has been selected here. Okay, and then for the circular plate, pick it through this. If you select the more than 50% part of this plate, then the circular plus cylindrical, bottom part of the cylindrical, both plate will be selected. So please, whenever you select it, try to select only less than 50% part of the above plates. That's mean it will be only selected if you cover up the more than 50% part of the slab. So due to this, you can select it. Now you can do one more thing. The bottom plate is parallel along the XZ plane. So you can select it through the plate parallel to XZ option. You will get it under the select menu. Here, come to the plate panel this time. Up to this point, I explained the beam parallel to X and Z. So here for the plate, we have an option plate parallel to, it is parallel to XZ, okay, X and Z direction. So you can select it according to that, okay. But this, you can't select the circular plate. Let's see, if I select the plate parallel to XY, nothing will be selected, or plate parallel to YZ is also. That means for the cylindrical plate, we have to select it from the front view only, okay. So that is the procedure of selection of the structures. So come to the properties again. Yeah, so I am going to assign it to the view here, so that every will get its property. Now that is the property 1, 2, and 4. 3 is missing here because I just deleted. Now come to the support options. So create a fixed support here and add it. Just select the support 2, then assign it to the bottom nodes. Then click on assign to the selected node option. Next thing is your loading. So here in the loading, let me check the loading load case details. So first is your dead load, and again they are adding a combination only. Okay. So under the dead load, you are seeing SW, that is the self weight. Then after that, it is written hydrostatic pressure on side plate. And third one is the base plate. Okay, so there are total 3 types of load cases will be created under the dead load: self weight, hydrostatic pressure on the side wall, plus base plate. So hydrostatic pressure can be defined through the trapezoidal load cases also. That means trapezoidal location means value of the pressure will decrease when we change the position. Like I can say let me explain it. Yeah, so if we fill the water here at the top, you know that at the bottom point, this bottom point will suffer the, will face the most pressure, because here at this point it will be the pressure of itself plus the weight of the water also. So at the bottom, weight of the water will be more, and at the top it will be less. So we can say under the if it is a it is the ideal condition, at the top the pressure will be zero, because we calculate the pressure with the formula of rho gh. Rho means density of water multiply by the gravitational force, and h will be depth. So at the bottom point here the depth will be 2 meters, and at the top depth will be zero. But you know that ideal condition is will not occur anywhere, so that's why here at the top we have to provide some value of the load also. That means we can say the pressure at the top will not be zero due to the viscosity, that is the viscous property of the water. There will be a viscous force between the layers of the water, and it will create a minimum pressure value. Okay, so that's why at the top we can't put the value zero. So that is the type of hydrostatic pressure, or we can say the trapezoidal pressure. That means at the bottom pressure will be highest, and as we will move towards the topward direction, the pressure value will increase gradually, sorry, decrease gradually. Okay, so now how to define this pressure value, let's see. Come to the stat again and up to the load case detail, click on the add. First I'm going to add a dead load DL. Here in this project only the dead load is created, so I will create the only dead load here. So under the dead load, first thing will be add your self weight, then assign this self weight to the view. Next thing will be your plate load, because you can see it is the hydrostatic pressure on the side plate. Okay, secondary thing here, you see that it is a plate structure, that's why we have to provide the pressure through the plate. So we have total two types of pressure here. First one is pressure on side plate and plus base plate. So first I will assign it on the base plate, because assigning on the base plate is very easy. So base plate means pressure on full plate. The pressure on the base plate will be same, and it is given 20 kilonewton. So due to the gravity, I will put the value minus 20, and the direction will be gy. It will be your global y direction. Add it, then close. So this gy will be assigned on the circular plate. So we can select the circular plate through the select menu parallel to the xz plate, then assign this value to the selected plate. Now for the hydrostatic load cases, come to the dead load again, click on the add, come to the plate load one more time. Under the plate load, we have a trapezoidal load case and hydrostatic load case also. So here we will use the hydrostatic load case in case of a rectangular water tank, or in case of a swimming pool. Mostly we prefer to do the trapezoidal in place of hydrostatic, because under the trapezoidal we have the direction of pressure. But in case of cylindrical water tank, we can't define the direction of pressure. Will anybody tell me what should be the direction of pressure on the side wall of this water tank? We can't define the direction, because it will be towards the every direction. That means along the x, along the z, and at an angle of from the x and z also. That's why we can't define the global direction here. But in case if it is a rectangular water tank, that means in that condition we can define it along the negative x, negative z, positive z, towards the positive x direction or towards the negative x direction. But in case of cylindrical surface, you know that we can't define it. That's why we use the hydrostatic pressure here in place of trapezoidal case. Is that clear? When to use the hydrostatic and when to use the trapezoidal load case? Please answer. Is it clear to everyone when to use the hydrostatic and when to use the trapezoidal load case? I'm waiting for the response. Okay, so
can somebody respond, please?
Okay, so I'm just going to continue. Let's see. I will explain it one more time. Let's see. In case of cylindrical surfaces, it is very difficult to give the exact direction of pressure. But in case of rectangular conditions, we know the direction of pressure. It should be positive x or negative x, positive z or negative z only. There will be only four directions for the water to calculate the direction of the pressure of water. But in case of cylindrical, it will be along any angle also. That's why here we will use the hydrostatic pressure, not the trapezoidal load case. Okay, so come to the dead load again, click on the add, and under the plate load we will pick the hydrostatic here because our structure is in cylindrical. Cylindrical surface. Okay, now yeah, you are seeing that nothing is visible here because for the hydrostatic pressure, first we have to select the objects on which we have to assign this value. Okay, so we will select the plate through the select plate option that is available here. Okay, so click on the select plate and select all the cylindrical plate through the front view, pick the plate cursor and select them, and make sure don't select the circular plate here, only select the cylindrical plate. Okay, then click on the done. Now you can see the option is available here. So W1 is at the bottom, W2 is at the top. So at the bottom we will provide the value to 20. Here we will put the value positive 20, not the negative, because this load that will act on the direction of the on this side plates. This is not acting on towards the negative gravity direction, because for the gravitational purpose, for the gravitational direction, I already assigned it on the circular plate. Okay, so that's why here we will put the positive value. Next thing, you can see it from the top view. The pressure on the sidewall is interpolating along the, y direction. Okay, ये आपके y direction के along ही यहाँ से चारों तरफ घूम रहा है, but direction of pressure you can't define. So that's why in this software, to overcome this type of conditions, we have a local z direction. So whenever you create the structure through the structure wizard option, as I created it through the structure wizard, so always your local z will be towards the negative, so towards the outside direction. So I will verify this also. In this software, you will get here, you will get the local z only, not the local x and y, because the software is designed like this. whenever there is any cylindrical surface, then local direction will be along the z direction only. So here we will select the local z, not the global z or global g or x, because we can't define the global direction here. So we will pick the local z here. And at the w2, if I put the value 0, that means at the top this value is 0. So that's why we have to change the value here. So I can put the value 1 or less than 1 also. So here I'm just going to put this value 1. You have to put this value manually. Okay, you don't know the data for this, because at the top you can't calculate the viscosity, and you can calculate it, but we can say it is very complicated. So just assign an approximate value. And you know that in the second or third lesson I already explained, it is very difficult to calculate the exact load cases. That's why we most of the time we provide an approximate loads. Okay, in the software we always provide the approximate load values. Okay, so I will provide the value 1 here at the top. Okay, w2 is at the top here, and the at the bottom I provide the value 20, and at the top it is 1. That means the pressure from bottom to top will gradually decrease. I will verify this also. Just wait. When I click on the add, let's see here the trapezoidal. You can see it here also. I just add the hydrostatic load, but you can see the name is trap. That is the trapezoidal load case. Okay, it is a type of trapezoidal load case. Hydrostatic load case is also a type of trapezoidal load cases, but I already defined when to use the trapezoidal directly and when to use the hydrostatic. Okay, now I am going to first thing I will show you the direction, local direction. So for the global direction, press shift plus I. So you can see the green arrow is showing the z axis. Okay, now press shift plus O. Pressing the shift plus O will show you the local direction. Now come to the bottom node. So here you can see towards the outward direction, you can see it is a green arrow. Green arrow means z axis. I can show you from the global direction also. You can see it here. It is green color is along the z axis. Now press shift plus O. Same, just check at the bottom node here that the z axis is towards the outward direction. You can see it here also. Okay, so that's why the software is designed everything like this. Whenever cylindrical surface is available, the outward direction will be along the local z. Okay, now going to show you the trapezoidal load cases. So let's see. Yeah, so at the first there is a plate, cylindrical cylindrical plate, and if I select the plate cursor here and pick this plate, that is the plate number 182. Okay, so here in this plate there are total 4 edges. At the bottom point, these both point will face the same value of the pressure, and at the top node it will be less than 20 kilonewton meter. Okay, value, because here at the bottom the weight of the water will be more in comparison to this point. Same here for this plate, the node value, the water load value at this point will be greater than the top point. Okay, so let's see, select any trapezoidal load case. So I just select the trap JT. Now I am going to zoom it. You can see the arrow size at bottom is greater than the arrow size as we are moved towards the topward direction. You can see it also, arrow size is going to decrease as we are moving towards the top direction. Okay, and it is the trapezoidal load cases. Let me see here, it is the blue color. That means if I click on the here, that is, it is showing the direction, it is showing the this plate's value. So this is the trapezoidal joint. For the bottom point, it is 20. You can see it at the bottom, it was 20. And at the top, it is 16.83. Just after this, next plate will be here. So at this point, it is 16.3. So you can see it again here, just above this plate, the bottom node will be 16.83 and the top will be 13 point something. You can see it here. Same after this 16 point values, next will be here. Okay. So when I pick the last value, that is the 1, 1, that will be at the top. So at the top, you are seeing the value is 1. And just below this, it is 4 point something. So I just put the value 20 to 1. That's why at the bottom, it is 20. And at the top, it is 1 kilonewton per meter square. Is it clear to everyone? Is this trapezoidal load case is clear to everyone? Well, if it is clear, then now come to the next point. That will be your analysis process. So before this, I will create the load cases also. Yeah, one more thing. If there is a live load also, then how to create the repeat load? So for the load combination or repeat load combinations, if you want to create a repeat load, so just select the load case detail, click on the add and select the loading type to none here. And click on add. Then after select the load case 2 and click on the add. Here at the bottom, we will get the repeat load. So if I define the dead, live, wind, everything, so you will get all the load case detail here. Then just pick the load case according to you. Then put the factor values which is required. So in the last assignment, which we were doing like the RC frame here. So you can see here the condition was given. Just add the load case. Let me open it. Yeah, so load case was here, a repeat load, combination of dead plus live, value was 1.2 and 1.5. So just it is written not, don't use the load combination. So use the repeat load. So you can use the repeat load from here. Go to the add any load case with none name. Then after, from the repeat load, you can add the load factor values here. Okay. So here in this water tank, it is given to add a load combination only. So I will add it through the auto load combination. Select the load case detail, click on the add. Then after, come to the auto load combination, select the code according to the IS456 code. And the load combination category is the concrete. So that's why I will use the IS456 and click on the generate load. So here you will get three types of load combinations. Click on the add, close it. Okay. Now run the analysis. Go to the analysis command, select all, add, close, and run it. And after this, I will. So here we are getting 40 errors. Let me check. Yeah, elastic modulus not entered for the member solid number 31. Let me check. Go to the properties plate. Yeah, it is assigned. Actually, I just create, delete, and create it 2 to 3 times to explain these values. That's why we are getting it. Let delete and define it one more time. So maybe it will sort out your problems. Yeah, we are getting R1, R4 here, but it is not here. Let me define it one more time. Sometimes this software, this is a software's problem also. In that condition, you have to recreate the complete structure. You can't do anything else then. Yeah, so I will assign it to the view so that. this is a geometry properties, circular rectangular plate. Here I'm not able to add the plate thickness here. Let's run the analysis one more time. Let's see it from the utilities also. Command file.
Sorry.
Come to the properties, element, incidences, cells. Okay. Properties, member property, material property. Yeah. You can see the member properties is assigned here. Support properties also assigned, but not the. Properties here. This is also not assigned. Come to the front view, then assign it. Beam property is also missing. So you have to assign it one more time. Let's close it. I just got it. I just missed the beam properties. So let me close it and assign it. Then assign to selected beam. Now come to the plate one more time. Through the plate cursor, select the plates, assign to the plates. Let's save the project one more time. Let me close and open the software. So this is a software bug only. You can see that I'm trying to assign the properties, but still I'm not able to do this. So you have to reopen the software. Sometime it will sort out your problem, or sometimes you have to create each and everything one more time. So let's see. Yeah. Come to the properties. Let's give the thickness 0.15. Add, close, and assign this value to the view. This time it has been assigned. Come to the analysis command. Performance currency print all is already assigned. So just run the analysis, save it. Yeah, so you can see it now. It is done. So I didn't do anything else, just I close and reopen the software, and it has been done. Okay, so next thing will be just do the concrete design here. So for this, first thing, just change your input unit, close the stat output file, then change the unit to the custom unit to the mm and newton. Then after, go to the design, pick the IS456 code. After clicking on the concrete here, then you will be able to see the IS456 code. Concrete design. Here it is, IS456. Okay, come to the defined parameters. I will assign the FC to the 25, FY main to the 415 here. Maximum size going to put of 20 mm, minimum of 12, max secondary 10 mm, and min secondary of 8 mm bar, ratio will be 4. Now assign this value to the view. You can see up to the FY main will be assigned to the each part, that means for the beam column and slab. But from here, FY secondary, this is for your secondary reinforcement, that is your stirrups and all. So that's it will be assigned on only on the beam and column. I'm using the assigned to view option, but still it will be assigned on the beam and column only. Now come to the commands here. I will pick the design beam, then design column, then design slab also, because slab is also available here, then take off. For the design beam, select the beam only. Then assign it to the selected beam. For the column, select the columns which are parallel to the y-axis. Assign it to the selected beam. Element will be assigned to the view. All the element will get it. Now run the analysis one more time. So here we are getting 23 errors again. So let's see what is the error. So it will be most probably it will be your reinforcement error. So let me check. The design movement exceeds limiting movement of the resistance for the element 81, 83 and 84. So you can see it will be for the, you will get all each element numbers also. So here I will start with the element number 81. Before starting this project, I explained that the thickness of this plate is very less, and I'm sure it is for the circular plate only. Okay, so let's verify. ये मुझे तो पता है, but आप कैसे पहचानोगे? So just see it. So just see the plate number. It is 81 and 83. So come to the geometry, then click on the plate layout here. It is your plate layout. So when click on the plate layout, you will get the data for the plate here. If you don't click on the plate layout, it will be your beam layout. That's mean you will get the output for the, you will get the beam here, beam number only. If you want to see the numbers of plate numbers, you have to click on the plate layout here. Then after, just find the plate number 81 and 83, then 84. 81. So from the top view, you can see it very properly. So here it is 81. Okay, that is your triangular plate. It is in the circular plate, because in the cylindrical plate all the shape was your rectangular. Okay, then 83, it is also here. Then 84, that may, and what is the error? Design movement exceeds, that mean the reinforcement is exceeding, means concrete is less there. That mean you have to change the concrete value by increasing the properties. Okay, so for this plate I am going to give a thickness of 200 mm. So I just changed the unit, that's why now this time we are getting the values in mm. So I will put the thickness value to 200 mm here, not the 0.2, because it will be 0.2 mm. Okay, now assign this value to the all plate which is parallel to the xz, assign it to the selected plate, and run the analysis one more time. So this time we are getting zero error, zero warning, and zero notes also. Now come to the result. Under the beam design, you will get at the top it is 2 bars of 12 dia, and at bottom it is also 12. And for the column was your circular column, so here you can get 6 bar of 12 dia with a tire reinforcement of 8 mm at a spacing of 190 mm center to center, and the for the slab, come to the element detail, you will get it at the here. So reinforcement area at the top for the plate number 77 is 1135, and for at the bottom it is 216, and the, for the all other plates you can get it. So that is the procedure of applying. The our main focus on this project was how to assign the hydrostatic load cases or trapezoidal load cases. Okay, so up to this point, if you have any doubt, then please ask. Otherwise, then next session will be continue. Will continue at 2:30 again. Do you have any doubt? Then please ask.
Anybody having any query or any clarification, you can either type it in the chat box or you can directly interact with Mr. Amit.
Once again, why do we define load in loading cases? I think you are asking for the definition option. Like I explained in the wind load. Yeah, actually, these loads are a type of dynamic load cases, because this condition, it will depends upon the your zone. Like for the seismic and wind, you know that the seismic earth the acceleration of the earthquake will change according to the time, and same thing the wind speed will be different at a different time, and it is also be the different values for different cities. In the seismic, you know that there are total four zone 2, 3, and 5. So that's why we have to define for which area you are doing the wind analysis or seismic analysis. Then according to this, you have to give these values. We don't have this data in the load case. That's why we have to give it through the definition, because under the definition, we have many other options like type of the building structure, as it is a building structure or it is a transmission tower or anything else like water tank or other things. That's why few cases like wind load or seismic load, even like a vehicle loads, we have to give the vehicle definitions also, because for all these things we have different load cases, like different load codes. Like for the seismic, we have the IS 1893 code, and for the wind load we have the IS 875. For the moving load, that is the vehicle load, we have the IRC chapter 3. So all these things will be assigned through the definition only. Is that clear now? That's why we have to give the definition for these type of load cases.
Okay, but I don't think they have any more questions to be asked. So we close the session and we come again at 2:30.